Duisburg is Europe's largest steel location. Our metallurgical plant is one big, intelligent machine. We produce premium flat steel here around the clock, 365 days a year. To do this, we need ore, coal, hydrogen, and other materials, which are delivered by ship, truck, or via pipeline. The coal goes to the coking plant first, where it is baked at very high temperatures for 25 hours. The coke thus produced is cooled down. It is porous now and consists almost exclusively of carbon, exactly what is needed for the blast furnace. In the sinter plant, iron ore fines are prepared for further processing in the blast furnace. The iron ore is baked together in scorching hot air to form coarser lumps, namely, it is sintered. The next step is the smelting process. Iron ore, coke, and fluxes are continuously charged into the top of the blast furnace, up to 25,000 metric tons of material per day. Hot air at 1,250 degrees is injected into the bottom of the furnace, causing complex reactions at high temperatures. Oxygen is removed from the iron ore, namely, it is reduced. While melting, the materials descend to the bottom, producing hot metal and slag. In the so-called tapping, the finished hot metal and the slag are removed from the blast furnace at a temperature of 1,500 degrees. Steel mill gases containing CO2 are generated in a metallurgical plant. Within the scope of our research project Carbon2Chem, we convert these gases into valuable base materials for the chemical industry. This technology thus enables us to reduce CO2 emissions. It is, besides the transition from coal to hydrogen, a key element of our climate strategy. To avoid CO2 emissions, we will replace coal with hydrogen, which can fulfill the same function, extract oxygen from iron ore. In the existing blast furnace, only a limited part of coal can be replaced with hydrogen. We will therefore replace our blast furnaces with new units in the long term, so-called direct reduction plants where the iron ore can be reduced with the help of natural gas or in a climate-neutral way with hydrogen. The challenge here is that the new unit does not produce liquid metal like the blast furnace, but a solid material called sponge iron. That is why we will combine it with another unit, a power-operated melting unit. The direct reduction plant with a melting unit will seamlessly replace the blast furnace. By 2045, we will gradually replace all four blast furnaces at the Duisburg site. It is only in the steel mill that the hot metal is turned into flexible and formable steel. In the converter, steel scrap is added to the hot metal. This benefits the environment and cools the steel. After that, oxygen is injected, which lowers the carbon content. The result is crude steel. However, one steel is not like another. In secondary metallurgy, the chemical composition of the liquid steel melt is adjusted. Small quantities of manganese and chromium are added to the steel. It is alloyed. This way, more than 2,000 different steel grades can be produced. Every year, we develop new materials and research further applications of steel. How is molten steel turned into a sheet? This is where the continuous caster comes in, where slabs of different sizes are produced. Slabs are massive steel ingots, which can be further processed at our production sites. The process starts in the hot strip mill. A red-hot slab is rolled down to a thickness of a few millimeters by massive rollers. At the end of the 700-meter mill, the steel strip is cooled with water and given its specific mechanical properties. It is wound into coils and sold as so-called hot strip. In the downstream cold rolling mill, the strip can be rolled down to an even thinner thickness of less than 1 millimeter. Subsequent hot dip galvanizing protects against corrosion, which is particularly important for car makers. In the hot dip galvanizing line, the steel strip is heated and immersed in a bath of liquid zinc. The protective zinc bonds permanently with the steel on the surface. In the coil coating line, the strip can also be coated in other ways. Paint films and other coating allow the sheets to be immediately processed into finished products, for example, for facades and household appliances. We produce tinned and specially chromium-coated black plate, with and without organic coating, such as paint or foil, for a variety of sustainable packaging solutions. In the electrical steel plant, hot strips are processed into electrical steel, an indispensable material for electric motors and generators. They are also used, for example, for transformers' energy supply systems. From a technological point of view, steel is essential for the energy transition. Hot strip, cut-to-length sheet products and electrical steel, cold strip and packaging steel, uncoated, hot-dip, galvanized and coil-coated. We offer our customers a wide range of premium products. Together with them, we develop innovative solutions for their business and in a sustainable way. We deliver our steel to customers around the world for electric cars of the future, sustainable packaging solutions, modern household appliances, and many other high-tech products that have become a firm fixture in our everyday life. Steel is an indispensable part of our life, around the clock, 365 days a year.